Paltrocast.
Maria, thank you for doing this.
Of course, thank you.
As a mother,
I do.
There you go. So we'll keep being respectful of your time and prompt and quick, but your day's going good so far?
Yeah, it was super good. Dropped my first one off at school, kind of wrangling these ones. And
wow. Yeah, Bellator 268 is going to be your second fight. You are undefeated. Do you go around saying I'm undefeated, or is that just
absolutely not? Absolutely not. I have one amateur fight and that's it. I don't think I have enough experience to go around walking around saying something like that.
Well, your fight at LFA 100 was excellent. Listening to the interview you did afterwards, you talked about how you want to take things fight by fight. But
yeah,
in general, years to come, do you think you have years of MMA in you?
I do. I think I definitely do. A lot of people keep asking me, oh, is it like a one time, or are you just doing like amateur stuff? But this is something I've wanted for a really long time. I just had kids in the meantime, and so now I'm finally getting to do it, and we're gonna run home with it. So the goal is to be the best in the world. So this is what we're gonna do.
Right. Who or what was it that drew you into MMA in the first place?
Well, I trained at the lab like my entire jiu-jitsu, like starting jiu-jitsu and stuff, and when I was like 17, Crouch asked me if I wanted to do MMA. That wasn't really the goal at the time. And then I trained with our fight team to help another girl out, and I really wanted to do it then. My husband didn't necessarily want me to do it because he didn't want to watch me get punched in the face. And like that was something really hard for him to get over.
Yeah.
And then once a friend of mine started doing it, I was like, no, I want to do this. It's something I want to do. But then I just had, I got pregnant with my first son. And then after my first son was born, 25 months later, he was about 16 months old. And then I got pregnant with my second son. And then when he was about 9 months old, I got pregnant with my third son. And when he was about 3.5 months old, I got pregnant with my daughter. So it was just, it was a long road to getting here. But it's something I kind of always wanted to do. I really like being aggressive. I really like kind of breaking souls, I guess, breaking people's spirits. Like, I think that's a wrestler mentality. I use those words because that's something like my husband uses. But I like being good. I like beating people. I like knowing that I'm good enough to beat them. And so that was kind of the goal, like the ultimate competition, you know?
Yeah. Both MMA and professional wrestling are full of successful couples, married couples who are both thriving in their industries. So what I'm curious about is, does MMA come up at the dinner table, or do you talk about everything except MMA?
I mean, it will come up every once in a while, but like more now, because we're both in camp, than anything else. Like, I'll have a question like, hey, what do I do with this? Or, hey, I'm thinking about this. What do you think? You know, but we're so busy with our kids that we don't really have time to have it our whole lives. We don't really watch fights on the weekends. Like I know another friend of mine, her and her husband watch every single fight, every single weekend, no matter what organization is, they watch it. We don't do that. Yeah. So it is kind of separate. It is not like our whole lives. Right now, while we're in camp, it might be a little bit more, but we have four kids, and our kids are our lives, not our career. You know, our kids are first, not the career. So it's pretty easy to kind of separate the two.
That's wonderful. What music do you like to train? Does the music matter at all to you when you're training?
No, not really. Ben, we have a iPod dock, and whoever kind of gets there first puts their stuff on. Ben, when he's in camp, he'll normally go unplug their phone and plug his in. And we listen from stuff from like more harder pop Christian music to love songs to like whatever, you know, depending on how Ben's feeling. We do listen to like love songs quite a bit, actually, while we're training. So the music doesn't really matter for me. I let my sons pick out my walkouts. I'm like, hey, what song do you like for mommy this time? So that's how it's going for me.
That is the best thing that I'm going to hear today. That is wonderful. And the last thing I want to ask about here is, in your LFA 100 victory interview, you mentioned you want to be an Instagram star.
No, I don't want to be an Instagram star.
Okay, so I misinterpreted the whole thing with one omitted word. So you don't want to be an Instagram star. This is
Yeah, my whole thing was, I'm not going into MMA to be an Instagram star. I'm not going in it to be a fighter. I mean, not a fighter, to be famous or to get my, like, a ton of money. Obviously I want to make money so I could support my kids, cause I have a lot of those and I want to do the same stuff my husband did for me. But the goal is to be the best. It's not to be an Instagram star. It's not to post my body all over Instagram and get followers just because I'm doing that. I want to be known and respected because of the time and effort I put in, not because I'm posting pictures of my butt and like how good I look. You know, I specifically do not want that. Right now my sister took over my Instagram. So she's posting a lot more stuff that I would never actually really post. But she's like, no, if you want, cause she's my manager now. And she wants me to have more, attraction coming to my account for sponsors and stuff. But I specifically don't want to be an Instagram social media person, whatever those are called. I don't want to be that. Influencer. I want to be a realistic person. Yeah, influencer. There you go. Yeah. I don't want to be that. I'm a mom and I want to beat people up and make them sad. That's
you're going to break souls. Well, Maria, yes. I look forward to your victory at 268 and you are inspirational. Keep up all the greatness that you're doing. And also best of luck to your husband as well.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Paltrocast.